We continue now at the top of Daf Kuf Chav Tes Amud Aleph in Masechah Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 129a. We're continuing now with a statement of Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel, who said that if a woman's just gave birth and her womb is still open, we're always Mechal Shabbos for her. And if the womb has already closed, so then Sricha Ani Bein Lo Amra Sricha Ani, whether she says she needs the item or whether she doesn't say she needs the item, Ein Mechal Asa Shabbos, we're no longer Mechal Shabbos. In that case, we do not consider it to be a danger. Now, the Mesoras HaShas brings a slightly different girsa from the Rush. Girsas Rush, Amra Tzricha Ani Mechalin, that even if it's after the womb has closed, if she says she requires something, we are Mechalal, Lo Amra Tzricha Ein. But if she doesn't say she needs it, then we're not Mechal. So a slightly different girsa in terms of what exactly Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel says. Now the Gemara says, Rav Ashi Masni Hachi, Mar Zutra Masni Hachi. That which we just learned from Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel, that's Rav Ashi's version of Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel. But Mar Zutra had Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel as follows. Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel, that Rav Yehuda said the name of Shmuel, Chaya Kozman Shakaber Pasuach, as long as the womb is open, Bein Amra Tzricha Ani, Uvein Amra Ein Tzricha Ani, whether she says she needs or whether she says she doesn't need, according to this Girsa, she's actively saying she does not need, Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos, then you're Mechal Shabbos, Nista Makaber, once the womb closes, Amra Tzricha Ani Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos, if she says she needs it, then we're Mechal Shabbos. Lo Amra Tzrichani, if she does not say she needs, Ein Mechalin Aleh Asa Shabbos, then we're not Mechal Shabbos. Once again, the Rush has a slightly different Girsa. Girsa's Rush, Amra Eini Tzricha Ein Mechalin, if she says she does not need when the womb is closed, so then you're not Mechalal. Lo Amra Eini Tzricha Mechalin, but if she does not say she doesn't need, so she just doesn't say anything, then we are Mechal Shabbos. No matter which Girsa you have, as the Gemara is going to say, it comes out that Mar Zutra is a little bit more lenient in this situation. So the Gemara now says, Amar Le Ravina L'Mereimar. Ravina says to Mereimar, Mar Zutra Masni L'Kula, Rav Ashi Masni L'Chumra. Mar Zutra here is going L'Kula. He has a more lenient opinion of what we do. And Rav Ashi is L'Chumra. Hilchasa Kaman. So who do we follow? Amar Le Halacha K'Mar Zutra. He said the Halacha is like Mar Zutra. Sofik Nefashos L'Hakil. Anytime you have a doubt in cases of Pikuach Nefashos, we are Mekel. So what's going to come out according to this Girsa of Mar Zutra, in Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel, what's going to come out is, again, if you have a woman who just gave birth, if the womb is open, so it doesn't matter what happens, we are always Mechal Shabbos, whether she says she needs, even if she actively says she does not need, we're Mechal Shabbos. If the womb is closed, so then it depends exactly what girsa you have. If you have our girsa, if she says she needs it, then we're Mechal Shabbos. If she doesn't say she needs it, meaning she doesn't say anything, even we're not Mechal Shabbos. If you have the girsa of the Rush in Mar Zutra's position, so then it's going to be that in the case where the womb is closed, if she says she does not need, we're not Mechal Shabbos. But as long as she does not say she doesn't need, as long as she doesn't say anything, then we're still allowed to be Mechal Shabbos, according to Mar Zutra. Me'emasai Psichas HaKever. So the Gemara now asks, at what point in time is the womb considered open? Amar Abaye says, Mishot Shateshaval Hamashbir, when she's on the birthing stool, that's already considered Psichas HaKever. Rav Huna Breid Rav Yehoshua Amar Mishah Shadam Shosas V'Yored. Rav Huna, the son of Rav Yehoshua, says it's from the time that the blood is coming out. V'Amri Lo Mishah Shachavrosa Nosos Osa Ba'agve. Some people say it's from the time where she can't walk around on her own. Her friends need to help carry her around. They lift her up from under her arms. Admasai Psichas HaKever. Now, until what time is the womb open? Meaning, when is it closed? Amar Abaye says Shlosha Yamim, 3 days. Rav Amar Mishmeid Rav Yehuda Shiva. Rav says in the name of Rav Yehuda, it's 7 days. V'Amri Lo Shloshim. And some say it takes 30 days for the womb to close. Amri Nahardai, they used to say in Nahardai, Chaya Gimel Zayin Velamed. When it comes to a woman who gives birth, there are three stages of halacha. There's within 3 days, within 7 days, and within 30 days of giving birth. Gimel, if it's within 3 days, Bein Amra Tzricha Ani Ubein Amra Lo Tzricha Ani, whether she says she needs, whether she says she does not need, Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos, or Mechal Ol Shabbos. Once again, a slightly different girsa brought by the Mesoras HaShas. It says, Bisfarm Yeshanam Hagirsa Lo Amra Tzricha V'chein L'Kaman. She does not say she needs. Not that she says she doesn't need, but she does not say she needs. So again, then we're going to be Mechal Shabbos. Zion, if she's within 7 days, Amra Tzricha Ani Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos. If she says, I need, then we're going to be Mechal Shabbos. Amra Lo Tzricha Ani. If she says, I do not need, again, you're going to have the same Girsa issue over here. Maybe she doesn't say she needs. Either she says she doesn't need or she doesn't say she needs. Ein Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos. Then we're not going to be Mechal Shabbos. And Lamed, if it's 30 days, Afilu Amra Tzricha Ani, even if she says that she needs it, Ein Mechalin Ole Asa Shabbos. We are not Mechal Shabbos. Aval Osen Al Yedei Aramoi. But we are allowed to use a non-Jew for her even at that time period within 30 days. Kid Rav Ula Breda Rav Eloy, like Rav Ula, the son of Rav Eloy, the Amar who says, called Tzarchei Chola Naasin Al Yedei Armoy B'Shabbos. When it comes to someone who's sick, you can always use a non-Jew to do that malacha for them on Shabbos. Uchid Rav Hamnuna, it's like Rav Hamnuna says, the Amar Rav Hamnuna, because Rav Hamnuna said, Davar Shein Bo Sakana, if there's something which doesn't represent a danger, Omer Lenachri Va'osa, then just have a non-Jew do it for the person who is sick. Amar Rav Yudah Mar Shmuel, Rav Yudah says in the name of Shmuel, L'chaya Lamed Yom, it says that for someone who just gave birth, we give her 30 days. L'may Hilchasa, what halacha, to what practical halacha does that apply? Amri Nahardoi L'Tvila, Nahardoi said that it applies to Tvila. Rashi here explains, L'Tvila Ad Lamed Yom Lo Sitval Mebnei Hatzina. The halacha is that if it's still 30 days from giving birth, she should not immerse herself in the mikvah at that point in time, even in order to become tahor, because we're afraid that it's going to be too cold and it's going to pose a sakana for her. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rava, Rava says, Lo Amarna Ela She'in Ba'alo Ima. That's only true if her husband is not with her. Avol Ba'alo Ima, but if she's with her husband, Ba'ala Mechamama, then her husband can warm her up. Ki ha devrati derev chista tavla begot los in yomen shalo befnei ba'alo v'itzdenias. There was a story with a daughter of Rav Chista. She immersed within 30 days of giving birth, and her husband wasn't around, and she was cold. Ve'amtoi la'arsa basre derava lepumbadisa, so they brought her bed to Rava and Pumbadisa. Rava was her husband, and when she laid with Rava, she warmed up and she was able to recover. Amar Rav Yudah Mar Shmuel, Rav Yudah says in the name of Shmuel, osin midura l'chaya b'shabes b'mos ha'geshamim. In the rainy season, in the winter season, you're allowed to make a bonfire for a woman who just gave birth, even on Shabbos. Savar mina l'chaya in l'chol alo b'mos ha'geshamim in b'mos ha'cham alo. They thought when they heard the statement that it's only for one who gave birth, not for someone who's sick, only in the winter and not in the summer. And the Gemara says, v'loi loshna chaya v'loshna chola loshna b'mos ha'geshamim v'loshna b'mos ha'cham. It doesn't make any difference if it's someone who gave birth, someone who's sick in the winter, in the summer, it's always allowed. Made itmar from the following statement, Amar Rav Chiya Bar Avin, Amar Shmuel, because Rav Chiya Bar Avin said in the name of Shmuel, Heik is dam and it's tanin. Let's say a person let blood and became cold. Osin lo medura, you're allowed to make a bonfire for that person. Afilu b'tkufas tamuz, even in the summer season, even on Shabbos, it's not a problem. Shmuel tzalchule tachsika deshaga. The Gemara says that Shmuel, he once let blood, and he needed wood for a fire. He was cold, so he took a very expensive chair. He took it apart, and he used the wood to make fire. Rav Yehuda Tzolchulei Psora Diyona. Rav Yehuda, similarly, he took apart an expensive table, and it was made out of an expensive wood. He used that for firewood. L'Rabba Tzolchulei Sharshifa. Rabba also, he used a bench in order to make firewood. V'yamarle Abai L'Rabba. And Abai said to Rabba, V'oka Avar Mar Misham Bal Tashchis. Isn't this a problem about Tashchis? You're destroying. Amarle said back to him, Bal Tashchis D'Gufoy Adif. It's more important the destruction of my body, Adifli, that's more important to me than this bench, and therefore you're allowed to do this. Amar Rav Yudah Marav, Rav Yudah says the name of Rav, Liolam Yimchor Adam Koros Beso, V'yigach Min Alayim L'Raglav. A person should sell the beams of his house in order to buy shoes for his feet. Again, this is a matter of health. It takes precedence over the Bal Tashchis on the property. Heik is dam, if a person let blood, ve'ein lo mayochal, he doesn't have what to eat, yimchor min alayim shebaraglav, he should sell the shoes on his feet, ve'aspik mayen tzarchei suda, and get some food for himself in order that he should recover from the bloodletting. May tzarchei suda, what kind of food is good for bloodletting? Rav amar basar, Shmuel amar yayin. Rav says meat, Shmuel says wine. Rav amar basar, nafsha cholaf nafsha. Rav says meat because you do a soul in place of a soul, the meat is in place of your own soul. Shmuel amar yayin, and Shmuel says wine, sumka cholaf sumka, he says it's red, goes in the place of red, since blood is red and you let blood, you let your blood out, therefore the wine, which is red, will replace the blood. So it's a question. So the other opinion says that the blood represents the nefesh, so you take meat, which is you killed an animal, you killed a nefesh in order to get the meat. Shmuel b'yoma David milsa avdi le tafshila de tachli. Shmuel, on days where he would let blood, they would give him cooked spleen. Rabbi Yochanan shasi ad nafik tia meone. Rabbi Yochanan would drink wine until it was coming out of his ears. Rav Nachman shasi ad de kafi tachle. Rav Nachman would drink wine until his spleen was floating. Rav Yosef Shasi Adinafik Mirivda de Kusilsa. Rav Yosef would drink the wine until you could see it come out of the area where the blood was let. Rava Mahadar Achamr Bar Tlasa Tarfi. Rava would look after wine that came, it was 3 years old. Rashi says that it was 3 years ago that the grapes grew, and since then it's grown three leaves. The vine has grown three leaves. So the point is, older wine of at least that age would be effective. Amar lu Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak l'Rabbanan. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak said to the Rabbanan, b'matusa minaychu b'yomet ha'kaza, amru lu v'esaychu Nachman ikla l'gabon. He said, please, on a day where you let blood, tell your wives that Nachman, Rabbi Nachman, is coming to us. And that way they'll prepare a lot of food for you because it's a health matter. Even if I'm not eating by you, if you tell them I'm coming, they'll prepare a proper meal. V'kulu irume asire. And he says all kinds of loopholes and cheating are usur. Bar mehaya rama d'shari. Except for the following. You can do the following cheat when it comes to business because it's an issue of pikuach nefashos of life and death matters. And that is as follows. Man de oven milsa. If a person lets blood, v'lo efshali, he has no way of getting any food and he's in a dangerous situation. Lishko zuza mika. He should take a piece of money that's not accepted. It's not real good currency. Velezel l'shev chanusa, and then he should go to seven stores at the time shiur reviasa and keep tasting wine. Of course, they'll reject his money, so they won't let him buy. So he'll take a little taste. They'll send him to the next store until he drinks a revias of wine, a quarter of a lug of wine. Then he'll be able to recover from letting blood. Vilo, and if he doesn't do that, lechol shev tamri uchmasa, he should eat seven black dates. Veleshev mishcha bitside, and he should put some oil on his temples. Vinigni b'shimsha, and he should lie down in the sun, and that will also help him recover. Avlet Ashkechel Shmuel Degani B'Shimsha. Avlet found Shmuel lying in the sun. Amar Lei said, Chakima de Yudah, you're the wise person of the Jews. Bisha Mihavitavi is doing something that's usually damaging, going to be good for you. It's not good for you to lie in the sun, so why are you doing that? Amar Lei said to him, Yomada Kazu, it's the day I let blood, and that's why it's important for me to be in the sun. Veloi, but that wasn't even true, the Gemara says. Ela'ika Yoma Damali Bashimsha Bekule Shasa. There actually is a day where the sun is good for a person. Yoma Danaflabe Tkufas Tamas. It's the day where the Tkufas Tamas, the summer solstice, when that happens, it's good to be in the sun. Vesavar lo iglile. And he thought, Shmuel thought he didn't want to reveal this to this person that this is a healthy thing. So he did that. It brings in the Mesoras Hashas, Svar Machairim Tevis. Some people say it's not the summer solstice, but it's the winter solstice where the sun is good. But in any case, he did not want to reveal to the, he didn't want to reveal to Avlet that this was a good day to be in the sun. Rav Shmuel, the Amri Tarvayu, Rav and Shmuel both say, Kol HaMekel B'Su'udas HaKozas Dam, anybody who's lenient about eating a meal after letting blood, Mekilin Lo Mizonosa Min HaShemayim, in the heavens, they're lenient with providing him for food in general. V'yomrim Hu, because they say about him, Achayev Lo Chas, he doesn't care about his own life. Ani Ochas Olav, God's going to say, I have to care about him, he doesn't even care about his own life, why should I provide food for him? Rav Shmuel, the Amri Tarvayu, Rav and Shmuel both say, Hayman David Milsa, person lets blood, Lo Leitziv Heichod De Karech Zika, he shouldn't sit in an area where the wind is blowing. Dilma Shafile Umne Umukim La Arvisa. Maybe the Arbisa, maybe the person who let blood did a job where he left him with only a quarter of a lug of blood, only a Arvisa of blood, which is the minimum you need to survive. The Asi Zeka Vashaifmina, and the wind will come and take away that little, even a little amount of Asili De Sakana, and he's going to come into a dangerous situation because he won't have enough blood to survive. Shmuel have a Ragel Vavin Milsa Bebased the Shav Lavinia Viaricha. So Shmuel, when he used to let blood, he used to stay in a house which had 7.5 bricks. Yom Echada, one day of it, he let blood, va'argish b'navshe, and he felt something was wrong, he felt getting weak. Badak v'chaser chad aricha, and he looked, and indeed, in aricha, a half a brick was missing. It was different than the way he was normally accustomed to. Rav Shmuel d'Amri Tarvayu, Rav Shmuel Bosei, Haiman Dov and Milsef, somebody lets blood, litom midi v'hadr leipuk, he should taste something, eat something, and then go out. Yilo toy midi, because if he doesn't taste anything, ipaga b'shichva yarka ape, if he meets up with a corpse, he's going to, his face will turn green. Ipaga b'man d'kotel nafsha mis, if he meets up with somebody who's murdered somebody, he's going to die. Ipaga, and if he meets up with, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Kuf Chav Tes Amud Beis.